Tobacco control advocates have called for a more effective implementation of available tobacco control policies nationwide. They say government must take advantage of the benefits of tobacco control, increase internally generated revenue, and protect citizens from the effects of tobacco use. Our correspondent Idong Joseph reports.
Available data says over 3.5 million persons have lost their lives to tobacco use in the past. Data further suggests that over 16,000 persons die yearly from tobacco use. Despite efforts to curb this growing trend, about 25,000 children aged between 10 to 14 years and another 7.4 million adults still use the substance daily. Tobacco control advocates, however, are optimistic that serious government worldwide can win the war against tobacco use. With this in mind, some advocates in Nigeria are calling on the federal government to move beyond gazetting Nigeria's National Tobacco Control Act 2015 and begin a radical implementation process.
There are a lot of researches, data to show that countries lose a lot in terms of what you spend on health hazards related to tobacco use, and that tobacco control in itself brings a lot of economic benefits. So we expect that our nation is going to gain tremendously from this particular law.
When you have tobacco control policies effectively implemented, everyone is protected. So that, because of course you know about the harms of tobacco. And it's not just the smoker who suffers diseases. All of us are at risk. So the effects of secondhand smoke. So when tobacco control policies are effectively implemented, everyone is protected and the whole country is healthy. And when everybody is healthy, then people can go about their business without having to go into hospitals and spend the little money that they have to cure diseases.
They say government must work toward providing adequate funds for the war against tobacco. They also want Nigeria's federal government to institute a committee that will work towards raising funds for an expensive anti-tobacco use campaign.
The Honorable Minister of Health should constitute another committee because he's the one so empowered by the Act to constitute a committee. Then it is the committee that will now take forward the conversations as regards tobacco control fund, because the tobacco control fund is supposed to be created to fund both the committee and every other tobacco control interventions in the country.
It's critical that funding is available to ensure sustainability of all tobacco control activities at all levels, at the federal, the state, and the local government. So the responsibility really is on the Federal Minister of Health to work closely with the Federal Minister of Finance to establish the Tobacco Control Fund as soon as possible.
With full belief that Nigeria can still win its anti-tobacco war, some of these tobacco control advocates are calling on government agencies responsible for the protection of citizens to rise up to the challenge and save Nigeria's future generation already getting hooked to tobacco use.
For us as CSOs, we will continue to monitor both the government and the tobacco industry's response to this new set of regulations. We know for one that the tobacco companies might want to challenge this regulation, and we just want to advise them, because they're going to lose the way they've been losing all around the world. This is a piece of legislation that we're ready to defend as CSOs, as Nigerian people.
We're going to continue monitoring to make sure that the policies, the law and its policies are fully implemented in our country. And that's why we CSOs, as we move from campaigning for the passage of laws, we're now going into a different campaign to ensure that enforcement happens.
Idong Joseph, Plus TV Africa.